But you just have to look and register and also go to places where the beauty is. I mean, if you stay at a place, at a concrete jungle, if you stay at a place where there barely isn't any nature, no wonder you feel disconnected from yourself, because it's not a reflection of yourself. Nature is. If you look at and contemplate and register, process, think about what it actually is that you see, what nature actually is doing, you reconnect to yourself. Like, simple symbolism from spring is the return of life after winter, especially at climates like Europe with the four seasons. And in February there are already promises of spring, little bulbs, how do you call it? These little bulbs of leaves that are still packed together tightly, protect each other. And then when the first warmer rays of the sunlight return, they feel safe to open up. The wind is still fresh, now that there's a cloud in front of the sun, I feel fresh, crisp air still. But when that cloud moves away again, the warmth will return. But my point is, I'm drifting off a little bit. I'm speaking a bit soft, low volume, because the phone is standing on the child wagon. I don't know the English word. My baby is sleeping. But my point is, go to places where the beauty is. And even at times and moments where it's difficult to go there because you're busy with work, you know, even between the pavement there are cracks, tiny plants, tiny forests, if you will, you know, that still grows there. You can still find the guidance of remembering who you are, reconnecting with yourself, with your own nature, even in the concrete jungles. But in every city there are parks. There isn't one place where there isn't any. Well, maybe in the desert or something, but you get my point. I'm trying to find a different word. You have the responsibility, or you know, for yourself, to bring yourself at places where you can experience this type of rest, where you don't actually sleep, but you just become one again with nature and become one again with yourself, and observe at what stage of the yearly cycle nature is in right now. There are so many ways how we can express this. And on one hand, I feel like what I'm saying isn't anything new, but I know for many people it kind of is. You know, I grew up with this with this lifestyle, I guess, because my parents took me to the forest, I think once a week. So I learned how calming it is, how, you know, nature doesn't ask anything from you. There are no distractions. It's so calming, and you can restore yourself, you know. Heavy energy that's in your aura can, you know, dissolve. The wind can cleanse it. And your mind, it's like a walking meditation also, really. there's nothing that you must. It's a literal translation, maar je moet even niks. Just breathe and observe and find beauty really. And I'm sharing this because it's something that I want to actively be thankful for in this moment, that I'm experiencing it right now. But also, I still see so many people that don't do this. And it's so simple. It's so, is it still wrong? Yeah, it's so simple, you know? It doesn't cost any money. You just have to bring yourself at these places. And I know that most people that don't do this feel very uncomfortable when they do. You know, they turn on music or they feel like they have to be on the move. They have to, you know, go to somewhere else again, and they feel as if they're not doing anything. But you never do anything. This is a way to slow down, restore yourself. Go back to a healthy rhythm, a healthy vibration. Feel support from the earth. Even sitting on the ground is so important. Feeling the ground, feeling the earth, feeling the wind, feeling the sun. Smelling nature also. Solar plexus chakra. I take actions daily that awaken my personal power. Right, this is an action that I'm taking, you know. I'm going outside, you know, to do some groceries and send out an order to a client and, you know, go to a playground with my baby, and now he's sleeping. And, you know, I multitask. This is so healthy for me. This is a daily action that I can take that awaken my personal power. But this is a very active card. But it's nice because I was talking about you never do nothing. Your cells are constantly renewing, your body is renewing, you know, your mind is traveling towards all types of places and ideas. And flames of wisdom, Crown, I'm open to all life's wisdom and share it with gratitude. Yes, I am. Are you? What does it mean to be open to all of life's wisdom? Talking about being open to truly observe nature and the surroundings. Places like this, you know, if you visit places like this even once a week, every week it's different. It's never the same. And so are you. You're never the same. So it inspires you. It inspires us. That change is a wonderful thing, and change is inevitable, it's necessary, and this little bug that just jumped on me. You see it? Yeah. What else can I say? I've been speaking about slowing down so much. This is an active way in which you actually can. Spirit awakens. I embrace my soul. I embrace my soul purpose and align all aspects of my life to it fully. I feel a bit torn between expressing more and just enjoying this moment. helps. It always does good to just do this and don't feel ashamed. Because I know many people don't do this because they feel uncomfortable, because they feel like they have to do something. But if you recognize that, that you feel uncomfortable with doing these type of activities, think about why that is. And also if you feel ashamed, if you worry about what people might think of you, that you just go sit on the ground somewhere random. Why is that? I was just, you know, walking around so that my baby could fall asleep. And I look at the front yards of houses a lot. I love that. It says so much about the personalities and the stages also of personal and spiritual development. And lately there are so many yards with fake grass, with very simplistic designs that don't take much effort. And I thought to myself, you know, if you have a busy life, I can understand that you choose for a simple yard that doesn't need much maintenance. But how disconnected to life are you? And then also, why would it be so bad if your yard, you know, grows wild? I mean, of course you want to make it beautiful and neat and not too crazy, but why are we so afraid to let nature grow? Why are we so afraid of growth and the unknown? You know, it's so, to me it's so beautiful to see how a plant opens up and slowly decides to grow towards the sun, and every plant has a unique shape, especially when they have the space and they are allowed to grow. And it's the same for us people. You know, if you keep a house plant in a small pot, you know, it tries its best because it's in its nature to grow as much as possible, but it can only grow till a certain extent because of that small pot. It needs a bigger pot, you know. It's the same with us people. If we stay at one place, physically but also mentally, you can't grow, you know. And back to the front yard, to the backyard. Some people maybe think that if your yard isn't super neat, then you don't have your life together or something. Or is there even a deeper layer where subconsciously they feel like they have to show other people that they are the masters above nature or something, that they need to control nature? You know, when I take a huge leap back into history where nature, parts of nature were actually a bigger threat for us. You know, when we hadn't any electricity, and you know, when the agriculture wasn't as it is right now, so we had to survive in nature more, where it was, you know, really a life of a matter of life or death, whether we had harvested enough to survive through the winter, and whether we had collected enough wood, you know, for the fire, for the hearth in the house to stay warm and stuff like that. You know, in those times, I understand where this need of control in nature comes from, because it's, you know, a survival instinct. But now it's so extreme. You know, we have to go back. We have to go the other way. We need to embrace the unknown, embrace the beauty of the wild things again. Of, you know, because the shapes are so beautiful. And it isn't a threat anymore for us. We need it. Open your mind. Truly look at nature. truly take a look at nature. Oh, it was very beautiful. It still is. I wish that everybody reconnects with themselves and nature. Try to find a solar plexus card again. You know, the dandelion, they see it as a weed, like a plant that's not important. But you can eat the flower. Here, I'll prove it. You can eat the flower. And you can eat the leaves and the roots are medicinal. Oh, I got a bit too enthusiastic, my baby's waking up. Something so common. Is an example of the abundance that most people don't even realize that it's here. The abundance of beauty, of food, of medicine. That nature just, you know, Mama Earth just grows. It's right in front of you. But if you don't even look at it and think about what it can mean, think about what it can do for you. Yeah, you don't know it. I think this was it. It's already 20 minutes. Maybe one last card. Conscious spirit. Again, the solar plexus. Take daily actions that awaken your personal power. Your personal power. Reconnect with your inner flame. There's the sun. Let the sun connect with your inner sun. That energy center inside of you that radiates and pulsates and supports the drive force of your passion, of the things that vitalize you like an eternal spring, the promise of return of life itself.